How long have I got, Tim? Oh, I've got ages. I just feel a bit grim, Tim. I haven't really slept. I've just spent the last 3 days defending Boris Johnson and, even worse, Jacob Rees-Mogg. Two of the worst people imaginable. All because of David Lammy. I know, lovely, cuddly David Lammy. Well, he compared Jacob Rees-Mogg and the ERG to Nazis. He implied Boris Johnson is a white supremacist. He compared elected Conservative MPs to the far right in Germany and accused the BBC of allowing extreme far right fascism to flourish. Makes my bum squeak, right? Because if it's true, fuck me, I just didn't see it. But it sounds to me like a complete misunderstanding of how history, i.e. the Third Reich, and politics, i.e. the British public voting to leave the European Union, works. He basically said that it doesn't matter if Johnson and Rees-Mogg are elected officials because the Nazis were elected too, which completely undermines our democracy. Boris Johnson is an opportunistic prick with no moral backbone whatsoever. His spine is made of spiteful gelatin. He's got Steve Bannon on speed dial and he is not to be trusted. He also was twice voted mayor of the most diverse city on the planet. I'm pretty sure he's not a white supremacist. Jacob Rees-Mogg isn't far right. He wants Brexit at any cost, not an ethno-state. The ERG are extremists when it comes to Brexit, not when it comes to ethnic cleansing. 29,000 people in northwest Somerset voted for Jacob Rees-Mogg to be their representative in Parliament. The northwest of Somerset is not known as a far-right stronghold. It's known for cheese. They didn't vote for a Nazi. They weren't hoodwinked into voting for a far-right extremist fascist by a mistake. To suggest they were is just wrong, and it fans the flames of division in an already dangerously polarised political landscape. What they did vote for is a man who looks like a drowned Harry Potter. I'm not saying hard-right populism isn't on the rise. Trump's in the White House, inside the EU, look at Italy. Salvini makes Nigel Farage look like Martin Luther King. The Netherlands doesn't get much more liberal than that, does it? All smoking doobies and shagging hookers over there, aren't they? Well, they've just lurched further to the right than fucking Goebbels. And they're here as well. They're here as well, ready to pounce. Look at fucking UKIP. As soon as that collapsed under the weight of its own irrelevance, look how quickly that was taken over by Tommy Robinson and his merry band of fascistic thugs. So we have to be acutely aware of this danger. We have to call it out where it exists. But you keep calling everyone a Nazi, you're going to have to find a new word for the actual Nazis. People who imply staunch Remainers are worse than the Nazis are the same people who helped get Brexit over the line in the first place. If you simply shout Nazi at anything you don't like the look of, you tend to lose the argument, or in this case, the referendum. We have to be better than this. If liberalism is going to survive this surge of populism that is sweeping the Western world, we have to understand why people are looking for alternatives to liberalism. Because clearly it's not working for them. When the left come out with this shit, we push normal people further and further away to the right by telling them they're already there, by telling people that large swathes of the Tory party are on the far right. You legitimise the far right by putting them all under the same umbrella. It's incredibly dangerous. Well, if the Tories are far right, fuck it, I'm going to start goose-stepping to work. See, he's got me defending the Tories, bastard. Our children are looking at us, all wondering what sort of country they're growing up in. And our politicians on both sides, our media on both sides, are telling our kids that it's leave or remain, it's left or right, it's black or white, it's right or wrong, that it's good or evil, that Corbyn's a Bolshevik and Boris is a Nazi, Labour are neo-Marxist anti-Semites and the Tories are Islamophobic neo-Nazis. You're either with me or against me. Populism thrives on this sort of division. Of course, David Lammy is the same man who laid into Stacey Dooley, of all people, for daring to have a picture taken next to an African child whilst trying to raise money for Comic Relief. The colonialist whore. She's lovely. I met her at the Pride of Britain Awards, right? We had a laugh because we were both complaining that the white wine was at room temperature. I made a laugh because And I'm live in central London. I'm going to be taking a look at how we can all reduce our carbon...